Welcome to JCE Connect. And today we'll demonstrate generation of triangular waveform. Okay. Now this is a program about to generate a triangular waveform using DAC interfacing card. That is a digital to analog converter card. Okay. Now when I say the triangle, the triangle will be look like this. Okay. Now like this. Okay. Continuous waveform. I hope you can see this will be like a zero, and this is, as we know, microcontroller 8051, it is of 8 bit port, are also having 8 bit, so maximum value I can reach up to 255. Okay, now the concept is that you first send a zero through the port P0, increment a content of accumulator 1, again you send this one through the port 1, okay, 2, 3, it will go on incrementing up till what value? 255. So that when you see at the output window, at the output port, you will find a positive rand will be appeared like this. Okay. Now similarly, when you decrement here to from 255, you will find a negative rand. So continuously, I'll get a cycle. Okay. Now let us come to the program here. Now line number 5. Okay. Move A,00H. That is, my accumulator will be loaded with 00H. Now L call output. Now what is the content of accumulator? 00. Now it will be calling the content of accumulator 00. It will be sent through the port P0. Okay. Now after sending it through the port P0 return, it will go to the line number 7. Okay. Now increment A, the content of accumulator is incremented by 1. Okay. Now this value will be compared with FF, because all the way I can reach up to 255. Okay, when is it equal to 255? No, means if this is finding a false, it will go to the line number 6. Again, the line number 6, L call output, it will go to the line number 16. That is a output move P0 comma A. Okay, now return where? At the line increment A. Again, I will be incremented to 1. That is 1 plus 1, 2, 3, 4. How long? Up till 255, that is FF. Okay, once it reaches a FF here, the loop will be broken. It will go to the line number 9. In the line number front line, I will load this value 255. A will be loaded with 255. Now again L call output. There is a long call output. Okay. Now what is the content of accumulator? 255. It will be copied. It will be sent to the port P0. Okay. Now I'll get it 1 point. Okay. Now return, where it will go? Decrement A. Now what is decrement A? Means FF minus 1, FF E. Is it equal to 00? No, up to. Okay, again it will be copied onto port P0. What is that? FF E. Okay. Return FF D, FF C, FF B, FF A. Like this it will continue. How long? Until this condition becomes a false. Okay, now once this condition is false, it will go to the line number 13. Okay, now this way I get here. Okay, similarly at the output, if you see, you will find a one triangle. Okay, like this, positive ramp and one decrementing negative ramp. Okay, now this is the one cycle what I get here. Similarly, if I want to loop it, if I want to get a n number of cycles, SJMP loop 1 means it will go to the line number 5, so that I will repeat my program. So since I'll get here couple of cycles appeared onto the port P0. This is the program to demonstrate how do we get a triangle waveform. Okay, now we'll see how do we generate a hex file of this one. Okay, as we know, the standard procedure, you need to go to translate, build and rebuild. Before this one, okay, now you need to be you need to click on a target, just a click, right click on this one, you'll find a options for target 1. Okay, for dump onto the program. Okay, now this window will be appear for you on the screen. Okay, once this window is appeared here, you click on target, see that the frequency will be 11.0592. okay, similarly at the output. Okay, now give the name of the hex file to be created for the corresponding program. Okay, now I mentioned here triangle. okay, and make sure that create hex file will be checked. And after this one, okay, click on OK. Right? Okay. Once if you're done here, now after the build, that is a translate, okay, build and rebuild, I hope you can see there will be a triangle name hex file will be created for you. Okay, now look at this. This is a triangle, okay, of hex file will be created. Means this is the file has to be dumped onto the hardware kit. Now, once the program has been created, hex file, go to debug. I'll show with a simulation here. Go to debug, okay. Go to debug, under which start and stop debug session. Okay, now your program will go into the debug mode. I hope you can see this window for you. Okay, now click on this window, logical and logic analyzer, and this window will be appeared for you. Okay, now here you click on run, so that run button we can see run. Okay, now immediately you will find a triangular wave will be appear. Okay, the triangular wave will be visible onto the screen. Okay, this is what, how, if you want to see. Okay, now you can stop it by stop. I hope you can see. And similarly, this will be like a positive RAM, what I had displayed here. This will be positive RAM, okay, and this will be a negative RAM, what you are getting here. Okay, since we are seeing this output onto the window, that is at the port P0. I hope you can see the port P0. Similarly, what we are seeing, okay, it will be go from 0 to 255. Okay, that will make the maximum value what it will be appear onto the port P0. This is the program. The same program you dump in a kit and see the output onto the oscilloscope. Okay. I hope the program will be clear. Try to execute and complete the session.